Get ready for cell phones on airplanes. HP introduces a new, small laptop. And artists use computer viruses to create masterpieces. All that news and more on this week's World Tech Update. Thanks for joining us on World Tech Update. I'm Nick Barber. We'll start this week in Europe, where the European Commission gave the go-ahead to move forward with the technical and licensing requirements for cell phone calls on airplanes. The airlines will still be able to regulate in-flight phone rules.
It's quite natural, it's a fact of modern life, that you have to make sure that there are zones of tranquility and zones where you can use the service. The airlines are testing different models, different business models. Some are thinking only about allowing data transmission, so email, SMS. Others will recommend that mobile phones are put on silent mode. That is all possible. But there will also be others who will allow you to talk 24 hours in the aircraft. That is, again, the question that for every airline is to decide.
A number of telecom operators and airlines are planning to launch the new service sometime in 2008. The new service recently got a chance to take a closer look at HP's Compaq 2133 laptop. It's based on a C7M processor from VIA Technologies and is available with Linux, Vista, or XP. Hard drives come in 120 or 160 gigabytes. A solid-state drive is an option on the Linux system and will be an option for the Windows versions in the third quarter. The machine weighs 1.2 kilograms. That's about 2.5 pounds. In addition to a more sophisticated look, the 2133 offers several advantages over ASUS Tech's Eee PC. The trackpad buttons are easier to use. There's two rather than just one on the Eee PC. And the screen's larger and has a higher resolution. Prices on the 2133 range from about $500 to $900 US, depending on user configurations. In our news and brief this week, there are some new folds in the Microsoft Yahoo saga. Earlier this week, Yahoo called Microsoft's threat of a hostile takeover counterproductive, adding that it's open to a deal, but only at a higher price. And according to a Wall Street Journal report, Yahoo is now in talks with Time Warner on a deal to combine internet operations with AOL, while News Corp is in talks with Microsoft to jointly bid for Yahoo. We'll keep you posted on more developments. At a San Francisco art gallery, an exhibit called Infected Art was on display this week. A Massachusetts-based computer artist analyzed the patterns in code from various viruses, worms, spam, and other malware, then represented that code digitally.
Message Labs provided me with data files of computer viruses and other internet malwares, and I created a computer program that looks for patterns and rhythms in these data files and takes those attributes and connects them to an algorithm that grows these 3D creatures.
To make this art, uncompiled versions of code were used so there was no danger of infection. The art isn't for sale, but security vendor Message Labs will use the images on posters and ads. Speaking of computer viruses, U.S. Department of Homeland Security Secretary Michael Chertoff keynoted at San Francisco's RSA Security Conference. He talked about how the government needs to develop an early warning system to mitigate cyber attacks before they occur. He also said the government is interested in partnering with the private sector on security issues and is looking for people to join the team who have a desire to serve.
My department is full of people. The military is full of people who left investment banking jobs, big law firms, lucrative jobs to come to work because they believed in something. And it's also good, you get really great experience and responsibility. But yeah, it is ultimately an appeal to doing something for the common good as opposed to your own enrichment.
After years of setbacks and delays, Europe is moving forward on their own satellite navigation system. Called Galileo, it's the continent's answer to US-run GPS. In the next 2 months, a process of picking technology companies to build satellites and ground stations for the system will begin. The deadline for the 30-satellite array is 2013, but right now, only one satellite is in orbit. A Russian rocket will launch the second Galileo satellite, GOV-B, at the end of April. The launch has been delayed almost a year due to a short circuit problem in final testing. Technology allows us to transmit our voice, pictures, video, and data, but what about smells? Japan's NTT Communications has developed a system that allows users to send fragrances from their cell phones. There are two components to the new system. The first is an in-home unit that is responsible for creating and releasing the various fragrances. It uses 16 vials and mixes the base scents, much like a printer mixes inks. Then, using your cell phone, you can pick from a variety of fragrance recipes on a website. After the scent is chosen, the command can be sent using infrared or email to the base station. NTT hopes the fragrance emitter will cost about $200 once available, but hasn't announced when that will be. Thanks for joining us this week. Next time on the show, we'll have a closer look and coverage of the launch of NEC's Louis PC, as well as all the major tech news. As we head out, we're going to leave you with post-game shots of the Boston Red Sox home opener. The defending World Series champs won their game against the Detroit Tigers 5-0. For all of us here at the IDG News Service, I'm Nick Barber. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.